It's been a great joy to have your church participate with us as you meet in our building. I pray for this church and for Pastor Powell every day. And so it is an honor to be able to come and share with you today. So first of all, I want to congratulate you on 6 years. There are a lot of churches that don't make it to 6 years. I planted a church back in 1989. And after the first 5 years of the church, in the same area there were 27 churches that started and died. So it is a testimony of God's grace here at Zomi Agape Christian Church. But no matter what God has done in the past 6 years, we must always stay true to what God wants to do for the next 6 and the next 20.
Amen.
It's important for us, especially at anniversary celebrations, it's important for us to reconfirm the foundations of our church. If we don't, we run the risk of thinking that it is by our strength that we have come this far. But no matter how strong you are spiritually, no matter how talented you may be in music and speaking, we don't want just a crowd of people. We want Christ to build His church. And so, this afternoon, I want to share from Matthew chapter 16.
Sasaria Flippi kam atun jiangin. Zesu ina nuzuite kianga mite il ming tapa ke kuahi hongji wehi yam jihin adong hi. Amau te in polkate polkanin tuifung pazo ang hi hongji wehi polkanin Elijah hongji wa polkanin Jeremiah ahi kele kam sang katapeu hidi hi no hongji wehi jihin tua chang yin zai su yin amao de kia nga tua yi ne no de yi ne ke kwa hu chi na yu yam chi yin ado chang yin simon pida yin nang pen anu ta pasien tepa kasi na yi yi chi yin ado hi tua chang yin zai su yin ama kia nga jona tepa simon o wai mama hi hi tu leitung pil na to Peter si na nangonin zozo ino lo di hi van tu ki una su lu na di to tang ti nang ma tu ma ka ho pe di nga hi le tu ma hui lo na chi te van tu nga zo hui lo hi hui lo hi di nga hi le tu ma hui hi na chi te van tu nga zo a hui hi di hi a chi hi.
This experience took place 6 months before Jesus died.
He took young man Jesus, aki ta, aki. Sinam de to aki hai ma kagupa abya to ahi hi.
He took his disciples away from all the crowds.
And aman mipila panina ano jite to umpay hiapi ina.
And he was trying to prepare them for the fact that they would have to continue the ministry.
Amal de na oba de su ano hisya ke jana bang chi na pi pasien na set na zom so te ing chi pen aman angai sna to amal de pa hian pi in.
And in this passage of scripture we learn three foundational truths about Christ's building of the church.
Here I mana ze isu ka te na po pi lam de ing to ki sai na tu tum na na gen hi.
The first thing we discover is that there's a pronouncement of Christ beneath us.
Ila mo na amasa pena iyan iyan tanjan na Christ jika kimoy na tuwa Christ na piniras na ama pen inwa ya ongi yung tong sapi.
There is only one foundation for the church.
Tuwa pen pulpi pulpi masa ahihi.
And that is Jesus Christ.
Tuwa pen Jesus kasi ahihi.
Jesus is the cornerstone.
Jesus pen in pangkyu kada om swang na khati.
If you don't have Jesus as the foundation of your church, you're nothing more than a crowd.
Khazi na pon pisunga pon kha bega pon na kyangele chingone na mi pisingelo ni hi.
You can go to a soccer match and find a crowd.
Na ben wa bolo su na ho en la mitam pitak ki muthe na li.
You can go to a basketball game or a football game and find a crowd.
Mitam bi ben to na chi bang na bolo su na te ya basketball ki mo na te ya ki mo to hi.
All those people gather together because of the foundation of a sport.
Bahang na to de nga mitam yam chi ta ja ma de ki kho na ki bo na ben bolo mo ki mo na kha ta pe ha ki ni hi.
But none of them are a church. None of them experience the blessing of Christ's presence in their midst. Jesus was asking the disciples to identify the foundation. We all know that many, many people followed Jesus. But who did they think that Jesus was? Jesus asked the disciples, "Who do men say that I am?" Well, some say John the Baptist. John the Baptist had been beheaded. And Herod wanted to meet with Jesus. But Jesus hadn't met with him.
But
in fact, there was a rumor going around that Jesus was the resurrected John the Baptist.
Some
people thought Jesus was Elijah. Malachi chapter 4, verse 5 says that Elijah must return before the day of the Lord.
Malachi dan lihat yang mana supaya tajana Elijah pen ohi kiri na om baik kiri hiji pen ke arah yang mana tua agen nawa hiji.
Some say Jeremiah.
Pokat dia na Jeremiah kapsan Jeremiah kiri hiji na ngai sunuhi.
And still others thought, oh, he's just one of the prophets.
Ah, pokat dia leh na ohi pen pen kapsan kat pen om baik kiri kene cina ngai sunuhi.
The interesting thing is that all these answers were wrong.
Ingat sedingin tua akhir domba sah tengah domben kacau malui.
All the answers were about someone who was to come before the Messiah.
Tua agen tengah domben Messiah maha apa ini agen hi.
And when you define Jesus wrong,
gentenara Yesus nak hiat pen kehiat kalajin.
When you don't know the real Jesus, you don't have a foundation. Jesus said in John chapter 8 verse 24, unless you believe that I am he, you will die in your sins.
Tuat pasien yang mana upah hiji nop kene nanggo nangena nasidihi.
So Jesus asked the disciples, "Who do you say that I am?"
Tuai menena tu pas Yesus na anu jeda kya nu ele kepa uji.
Peter speaks up on behalf of the whole group.
Pita mai na alom te tangena ama ungen kya hi.
You are the Christ, the Son of the Living God.
Nampen kasihnya hihi, pasien tepana hihi, hihi.
Jesus lets him know, flesh and blood didn't reveal this to you. Flesh and blood did not reveal this.
Tolak tak kena si buat nama om Nailohi itu pas Yesus na, ayatnya.
But my Father who is in heaven.
Kapa ina bantua om lagi.
The point is that Jesus is the Son of God.
Yesus ben pasien tepat tak hihi,
and he is the foundation of the church.
Ama ben popii popi hihi.
Never start to think that the pastor is the foundation of the church.
Popi kipat na ben foundation popi ben pasar cik bang nang ayam nang kangen keun.
Never begin to think that your cell leader or any other person is the foundation of the church.
Bagaimana nak popi semua makai kat betul. Ipat kiri cina cuma orang nak isu pakai un.
The only way this church will continue to be strong is if its foundation is Jesus Christ.
Yesus kasih nak popi, popi ahihi ahina lebih popi berkhantori ahihi.
The Apostle Paul in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 1 and 2.
Korintu masalian ni ada ni na.
Said when I came to you, brethren, I did not come with superiority of speech or of wisdom.
No, yang aku umpai na ina, pasir khas yang tu umpai na betok umpai kahihi.
The Apostle Paul saying, I'm not the smart one. I'm not the one that you should build your church upon.
Kepen no te popi umpat, no te popi ipat tenina kepen siapa na kepen kahihi.
But in 1 Corinthians 2 verse 2, he says this. For I determined to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Christ and His identity is the truth upon which the church is built.
Tuamana kasihile ama kasihi na begina popi arina tuman tutak hihi.
Now it is the proclamation that Peter made that Jesus said, "You're right."
Tuamana dena kita nanti pitana ada kipen nang mani cina tobat Yesus bagian pahi.
There are many religions that define Jesus differently than the Bible.
Lajanu tu elenzo ngayon sa pen, popi minang popi ta, tuwantotena. Yan na tuwantotena, tuwantotena na nakiyawgi.
Some claim that Jesus is actually the brother of Satan.
Pokatena, tuwa Jesus pen, Satan ilogi jilahi.
Still others say he's like Michael the Archangel.
Pokatena, Michael, vandumi pate, aki pokati dihi jilahi.
The only correct answer is that he is the living Son of God.
Aman pen bang yam cita jana to pa jesuin anung ta pasien ta patak ta hi jina hi.
And as long as the message of Jesus is the message of this church, the church will continue to grow.
Tua jesui ongen kamma tu betina hi popi ongka son pitak zoni hi ongong tak pini hi.
Now in this passage that we're looking at today, Jesus makes a promise. He says to Peter, upon this rock I will build my church. Now, Peter was not the rock. Jesus is not saying, Peter, I'm going to build my church on you. The truth is, the church is built on the truth of Jesus Christ. Some believe that Peter was the first pope.
Peter ben Bogatena.
And that he has this great power in the church today. But I want you to notice something about what Jesus says in his promise. He not only said, I will build this church, he also said, the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it.
Kemaina pompi kalamdinga tua pen kuama kuamaina tosu sesoluri hichina anakiani.
Now what he was saying here is that death cannot prevail against the church.
Tomena tua si na nangon ina pompi sesoluri hichina ilaya kamjam piahi.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet he shall live. The Bible says in Acts chapter 2 that Jesus could not be held in death's hands. In Hebrews chapter 7, it says that Jesus had an indestructible life. Now this is important. As long as you believe in Jesus, death cannot take you. We may physically die, but we'll never die spiritually. And it's upon that truth that Christ said, I will build my church. Okay, so you've obviously, there's some really talented people in this church. I mean, I was just enjoying myself. I had no clue what the words meant. But they sounded good. And you have great musical talent, but you know what? Music doesn't build the church.
music la siam ma 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 hi aya na de de una music hang ina pop ki la lo hi chi pe lo thai sa mo mi.
I love all the kids that are running around.
Na mo de ya kai ju tai do te ka mo chang in ma ma hi.
I have 5 children of my own.
Ke no ma ha ne hi
grandchildren.
Tu ma ne hi.
It's great having them all over the place.
Ento te to ka mo chang e ke ka lo na ma ma hi.
But children don't build the church. It's clear that there are some individuals here that love Jesus. You have good leaders at the church. But they don't build the church. You have a wonderful man as your pastor. But he doesn't build the church. Who builds the church? Jesus does. He made that promise. And when Christ builds the church, nobody can take it down. Christ is the life of the church. The Bible says, in him was life, and life was the light of men. Now there's one thing I want to point out. It's the last point of foundation. It is the permission that Christ gives to the church. Okay, now this is difficult to understand because there's so much misinformation. Jesus says to the disciples, I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. And when he says that he'll give them the keys of the kingdom, he's talking about giving them authority. There is authority that the church possesses. But the authority is not ours alone. It is given authority. This is what Jesus says. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And he says, whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Now some would think that what Jesus is saying is that if we decide to bind or loose something, then heaven has to respond by binding and loosing. But that's not what Jesus is saying. He's not saying that we decide what to do and then heaven has to respond. The way the original grammar is in the Greek language, it says that whatever we bind should have already been bound in heaven. Here's the way it worked in that culture. When Jesus talked about binding and loosing, they were very familiar with that concept. And here's how it worked. Let's say that I wanted to learn if it was okay for me to purchase a piece of property. In those days, they would have big, giant city gates. It might be like this room right here. And from one side, you would enter into the city gate. There would be some people selling things around the center of the gate. And the city elders, the wise men and the scribes would be sitting in a corner. And so if I wanted to purchase a piece of property, I would have to find out if that property was available. So I would walk up to one of the elders, and I would ask, does the law permit me or bind me from purchasing this
property?
So I would go away and they would talk about it. And they would look in the records and they would look in the law.
And
then I would come back. And they would say one of two things. Either you are loosed and free to purchase that property. Or you are bound and cannot purchase the property. Now you see, the scribes, the only thing they did is look to find out what the law said. They did not have the freedom to decide what the law said. They could only proclaim what the law said. And that is what Jesus is saying here. The church has the permission not to proclaim whatever they want. The church can only proclaim what God has already said. So, if you share the gospel with someone, and they refuse to accept it, you can proclaim that their sins are not forgiven. But are you the one who decides whether their sins are forgiven? No, no. You're only proclaiming what God's word has already said. If you want to stay strong as a church, you must stay close to this book. Do not go off to the right or to the left. Do not proclaim things of your own imagination. The message that you proclaim must always and only be God's word.
Amen.
Now let me tell you that Christ made a promise to build his church.
tamena khasina polpin lam deringa kamcham khat pelahi.
And Christ is faithful to fulfill his promises.
Khasi ben ong kamcham mangina ong tang sukta ong tang kong sakai tu tuman khasi ahihi.
But Jesus never promised to build the church in the local body of believers at ZACC.
Tamena polpin lam tajena hi kima umteng beto lam dingji to panong thalawa hihi.
Have you ever seen or heard of a congregation that has just lost their blessing?
Popi sungai do mi sunga amalti tupa asuk tena zangyum hiyam.
The seven churches that we find in the book of Revelation.
Revelation ma'amuna sunga popi sangi.
Some of them lost their love.
Amal polpi sunga pokatena inakiam tikimutehi.
Jesus said, if you don't repent, I'm going to remove your lampstand.
Pamena no nakisikyone na meva buken lahedin china na nakian niyan yati.
We should not try to build the church by the wisdom of men.
Pamena polpi pen mihi ngasusiam na lepil nato.
We should always proclaim the truth.
Lamlo ni langa so baka mandek yan niyan.
Some will reject that truth. But Christ will always build his church. And if you want Christ to continue to build Zoe Agape Christian Church, then you must cooperate with Christ. We cooperate with Christ by not compromising our holy testimony.
Pamena Jesu katito kipoksok na chipen ei sep tomnate ei hancham tomnate hirohi.
God has called you to be holy as he is holy.
Jesu katito ben parantele siang tu nun ta na hina pasienina keikan nun kasian tu mamana ote nun siang tu di ichi.
Discipline yourself for the purpose of godliness. Be salt and light in the world. And never compromise the truth. I love the song, the B-I-B-L-E.
Then
I was singing that song 55 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's true. What is the source of our wisdom? What is the truth upon which we not only are saved, but we have peace?
Tamana ite i hancham na to pamma la luman na lowa kasi hambe na luman na ani.
It is the truth of God's word.
To pa Jesu ni kamma pekma ahihi.
I believe that Christ will continue to build this church.
To pa na hipo pi ulang to do la jing na kalamen hi.
Because what I hear and what I observe are people who love the truth.
Tamena kapopi sunga miteto no teto kawe jagana to pa Jesu ai miteto kalsuan som tehi.
And as you cooperate with Christ,
toena to pa to nakipol som na hihi,
he will build his church here.
Ama ina hilaya ama popi ulam dehi.
And the gates of Hades shall not prevail against
it. Tamena sina na ngorina I popi sesam tulonihi.
Happy anniversary.
And kumpul cina lu dampi inge.